This episode of Shut Up and Listen is brought to you by the hot new dating site for felons, ParoleeHarmony.com.
Once again, got the makeshift studio going on. I'm sitting on a couch with a TV tray with my laptop and mic on it.
You are lucky you are not in the studio right now.
Is it blazing hot?
Oh my God, it is horrendous.
Well, I just want to let you know that it is a steady 69 degrees here in San Diego.
Sam, don't make me hate you.
Oh, stewardess, I speak jive.
Dude, you've gone 2 weeks without getting in trouble on Facebook.
Yes, yeah, I know.
I think we need a round of applause for that.
I do. Yeah, right there.
There it is.
I've been a good boy online. He went down for bed tonight with minimal fuss.
How much whiskey did you give him?
I'm not at liberty to discuss that information. Did you eat my gummies? And I was like, you're hiding candy from me. She goes, no, you idiot. These are prenatal vitamins. And I was like, oops. Thank you, Sam.
Who refers to Trump as dictator?
Fox News!
Fox and Friends co-host Abby Huntsman makes an on-air gaffe as TV footage showed the Republican president landing in Singapore for the summit of the North with the North Korean leader.
Fox News stuck up for the man. They showed pictures of several Eagles players kneeling. Look at them. They're protesting the anthem. They hate the military. They hate the White House. Turns out that those players were praying during warm-ups. Trump's Celebration of America event lasted 8 whole minutes. We reached out to Stormy Daniels for comment, and she said, yeah, sounds about right. One of the most hilarious things that happened during the G7 summit was when Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau gave Trump a picture of Trump's grandfather's first hotel in Canada. It was a brothel.
Well, coming back, let's talk something other than Trump.
What's up, Crunch? How you doing? What would you do if you were in a horror movie, psychopathic killer chasing you down? What would Crunch do?
First, most important thing, don't fall down.
I don't know if I could defeat Jason, but I feel like I could definitely stay ahead of him. I think we got a high of 75 today, so
now, I hate you so much right now. We will see you next week with a whole new batch of questions.
Yes, sir.
This has been Crunch. This has been Ask a Black Guy. White House staff is like, no, you can't do that. I don't care. I'm President Trump. And he tears all that stuff, so they have to come in with literal scotch tape and put all this stuff back together.
Kim Jong-un is not only being escorted by a motorcade.
Jogging guards.
What do you have to do wrong in North Korea to have to jog as human body shield?
What would really trip me out is if they all decided to quit at one time. Like, he's just driving down the road and you got the jogging bodyguards, and one of them says, you know what? I don't want to do this anymore. Come on. And they all just stop and the car just drives off. Well, I get all of this information from our esteemed and beloved long-distance producer, Becker. Instead of having the system that throws the aircraft off the ship, which is always steam, they now have magnets. They're using magnets instead of steam. They spent hundreds of millions of dollars. I'm not hearing great things about it. I have not heard one go, you know what? We were having such a good day and the magnets on the aircraft carrier broke and we couldn't launch any planes.
What it is, big mama. My mama raised no dummies. I duck a rap.
If you're paying attention, it is 4:25.
4:25 in the morning.
All your friends are sleeping and you are
sitting up doing a radio show at almost 3 in the morning. Do you lose respect for Tony Gonzalez when you went to Atlanta?
Did Tony Gonzalez throw a 2-hour-long me festival just to say I'm signing with another team?
Did LeBron do that?
Yeah. How you gonna be the greatest player in the world and get your ass tore out the frame twice? Would you rather pay $50 million to the guy who wins championships? Or would you rather pay $30 million to the guy that gets to the finals? Whenever he goes to his next team and he's like, I want max salary. I want the max salary. And then he loses again. I get to go back to you with a straight face and go, ha 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 ha. As a Penguins fan, it pains me to say that the Washington Capitals are the Stanley Cup champions. You feel good about it because Alexander Ovechkin, you know, he needed a cup and he got him a cup. So good on him.
He did.
The reason why I'm all mad about this is because now I got to deal with Capitals fans. The last time the Capitals were in the Stanley Cup Finals prior to this one, they got swept by the Red Wings. The Penguins have never been swept in the Stanley Cup Finals. And right up until 2008, they had never lost a Finals series. They've won the Stanley
Cup. And then in 2008, they lost.
Yeah. 4-2 to a powerhouse Detroit Red Wings team. I mean, that team still scares me. I wake up in the middle of the night screaming about the 2008 Red Wings. Oh my God! You got 5 Stanley Cups for the Penguins. The Capitals finally win one. Yes, they won the Stanley Cup. They beat an expansion team to get it. You know, normally I feel good about sports teams when they win, except for LeBron and the Patriots and Flyers because them. We're coming up on the end of Shut Up and Listen. We got about 15 seconds left. Sam, you got anything to say?
It's been great. Thanks for having me. I'll see you next week from the Tin Can in California.
Why do you always say that? You are part of the show. You are the reason this show exists. Thanks for having me. What's wrong with you?